Hello there. Welcome back to my Sims 2 Uberhood. My name is Brianna Peppers, and today we are in Strange Town, playing with a family that I haven't seen for quite some time, so I'm excited to get back to them. This is going to be the Beaker family, with Loki, Circe, and their two children, Falon and Owen. It remains to be seen if they're going to have more children, but I feel like I'm pretty happy right now with their two sons. And the sons are very young, so I'm not sure if we're going to get to see them age up today. We still live over here at 1 Tesla Court. I haven't done anything to remodel this house, at least to my memory, so we'll have to check it out when we go back inside. We also do not have a new description yet, but I am going to work on that possibly after we finish today's playthrough, just so I know exactly where I want the story to be headed. So let's go in here and check everybody out. Here we are inside the Beaker house, or I should say outside the Beaker house, and boy, oh boy, it's looking a little rough. I can see here that I did add a little driveway with some cacti, so, you know, that was nice, but they still don't even have doors on the house. This house is not exactly seasons-proofed. To be fair, they don't really have winter in Strange Town. It's just summer and autumn, apparently. And we look like we're gonna have some roaches outside as well. Let's go in and take a look at the Sims. You can see here that nothing about this house has changed. It's still the regular way that Max has built it, but something odd that I'm noticing here is that there's just a wall here, and I think that I might have had like the mysterious bookshelf here, but I can't understand why there's a crib now and not a door. I don't know what's going on. It's been literally like over a year since I played in this household, and like I said before in another video, my playstyle and my decoration tastes and everything like that have changed drastically. I would say that my tastes have changed. Up here we have, I've turned this second bedroom into Falon's bedroom, but we currently don't have a bedroom for Owen, which is why I'm assuming that there is a crib right here. This house needs some TLC, it really does. Let's take a look before we do anything though. This is Owen. Oh my gosh, and today is his birthday, so that's gonna be exciting. We'll get to see little Owen age up. Okay, so this is Owen, and he is a carbon copy of Loki. I don't care, like, he looks exactly like him. He may as well have just been Loki's clone. And up here, we have a better mix of Loki and Circe, in my opinion. This is Falon. He did have a different hairstyle, as you can see, actually, in that homework locator. But I've mentioned before many times that I have new default replacements, so some Sims are going to look a little bit different than they did in the introductions, etc., etc. So this is Falon. He's also going to become a teenager today. Oh my gosh, it's our lucky day, guys. We're going to get two age-ups. I'm so thrilled with that. And here's our personalities as well. Falon is an Aries, so he's extremely neat, outgoing, and active. He's more on the serious side, and he's a big fat grouch. Like, he's the grouchiest grouch you've ever grouched. For some reason, though, I can see here, I don't know how well that's going to translate to the screen, but I do see that underneath his grouchy, like, you know, personality points, that he did originally have one, but I suppose it's possible that either Loki or Circe have encouraged him to be grouchier, so he lost that personality point. And I can also see the same, he had one more personality point in playfulness, so, I guess that's probably what happened. Someone encouraged him to be more serious and more grouchy. And naturally we have Loki and Circe over here in their bedroom. Loki's actually waking up for the day. And yeah, like I said, he looks exactly like Owen, and he's pissed at that girl. I'm not sure who that is, actually. I actually don't remember a lot about what happened in this household last, so let's take a look at their memories. I know that Loki has recently, like, fallen in love with Miranda Cap, but, or so I thought. Maybe that was someone else, but, he did have an affair with Miranda. He actually went as far as woohooing with her, but that was a while ago. Like, that was after they had their first son, and he hasn't really had a whole lot of contact with her since. As you may remember, Miranda Cap is actually now married to Benedict Monty, so she's actually Miranda Monty now, and she has a child of her own, so they don't really have a lot of contact. He did also have a brief affair with Nina Caliente, who is now Nina Curious. She married Vidkun Curious. However, things did not really progress there. I think Nina was just kind of like flirting with Loki, but things never really went anywhere with that, and she decided that she kind of wasn't interested in him. So that's kind of what was happening. I know some people don't think that Loki is the type of man that would have an affair. Obviously, I'm not condoning affairs. I did have someone comment not long ago on one of my videos that I was condoning cheating because all my Sims cheat or something like that. It was a really weird comment, which is the first of the kind that I've had like that. But it did make me think. I definitely don't want it to appear like I condone cheating or affairs or anything of that sort, but I just want to remind people that this is a game and that cheating is a core, like, drama factor built into The Sims 2, Loki. So it's just kind of like something that you do in the game. Like, I would never condone doing that in real life. So that's my little cheating disclaimer, I guess. I didn't really think I would have had to do something like that, but just wanted to put that out there. Over here we do have Circe, and so Circe's not really innocent herself either. She has had affairs as well. In fact, specifically one that I can think of with her friend, who, this is the townie that she's automatically friends with at the beginning of the game. So sometimes, depending on, I guess, which template you have, he's got different names. In this template, his name is Roger Benson, and they have woohooed, so... Yeah, I don't know. I think that Circe actually went and did that herself. I don't think I even had anything to do with that, so... Yeah, since they're not romance sims, I would never force them to cheat. It's always just like either someone else has come onto them and they accepted it, or they just went out of their way to do it. So it is Friday morning at 7 a.m. Falon is going to have to go to school, and So yeah, it looks like Loki is going to go to work, and Circe works at night. She still hasn't had a promotion in quite a long time because I assume I've been keeping her home for her pregnancies. And now she has 10 vacation days to use, but we're going to keep her home again tonight, considering it's her son's birthdays, and she wouldn't want to miss that. Loki can go to work because he'll be home in time. Now, while I'm looking at this house in the broad daylight, I do think that I want to at least do some minor fixes to it. I'm not going to go all out and do like this whole like new house, but I think that it needs some things. If anything, I'm going to replace these arches with front doors and maybe find somewhere to fit in a bedroom for Owen, because the poor thing, he's about to be a child and he doesn't even have a room to call his own. So I will be back in just a moment and I'll get to show off the new look. Alright, so my too much gene definitely went off here a little bit, and it's actually several hours later. I did not mean for this to take so long, and to be fair, I did take like a couple breaks, so that's also why it's so much later. But yeah, I finally just reached a point where I said enough is enough. I need to just stop and just get into the game, because otherwise I'll just be here all night. And I started to get frustrated as well, because I was running out of like decoration ideas, and that's usually what holds me up for so long. And I was like, you know what, it's fine, like, not every square inch of the walls needs to be covered. It's gonna be okay. So without further ado, I'd like to show you the new Beaker residence. As you can see, I didn't change the shape of the house at all, because I have mentioned before, I hate dealing with like restructuring houses and like redoing the roofs and the floor plans. Like, I'm just generally not good at it, but I did my best, okay? So this is what we got going on. So on the first floor, it's the exact same layout, but I decided to do away, first and foremost, I got rid of the fireplace, because this family lives in a desert where I assume that it would be very hot all the time. I just don't see why they would ever need a fireplace. So that was the first thing to go. So over here we have like this living area. I'm gonna keep saying this, but it's pretty sparse. Like I said, I started to lose steam with the decorations. I decided not to do any coverings with the windows, because another thing that usually takes a lot of time for me personally is finding like the right curtains that fit every room and fit all the windows. So they're just gonna have these big windows that just look out on this alien crash site, and the ones on the other side of the house will look out onto the rest of Strangetown. They live all the way up here on the hill, so it's not like anyone else can really see into their house. Anywho, so yeah, I just got some new furniture. Owen is still in the middle of the floor, I had to move him. I also got some new stairs, which I'm actually really happy with how these turned out. These are just some regular, like, custom stairs I downloaded. They're called the Gruth stairs. I don't even know. Made by someone named Ul Mill. Yeah, I think I downloaded these and they came with like a custom house or something. But I'm really excited because I finally learned how to use these stair wall fixes I saw in someone else's video or something before. I downloaded them forever ago and I was like, oh, I don't know how these work. But then I saw in someone else's like streamer video, I actively saw someone use them and I was like, oh my god, that makes so much sense. So now I don't have like the awkward like empty space underneath the stairs. Now, this paneled wall might look a little strange with the wall, but you know what? I don't care. I've spent hours on this and I'm ready to just play, and I think that it looks good. I think it looks better than what it did. And we have the kitchen. It's pretty standard. I decided to keep their iconic little bowl of fruit, but yeah, I just pushed everything up against this wall rather than this wall. And they have a regular table and a nice little like wine corner thing. I don't know if they're going to be able to use this because of the diagonal placement, but I think it looks nice, so they probably will just have that for decoration. We still have this strange like outer foyer thing, I don't know. And then the bathroom is the same. I just put down some, this is like not a great angle to see everything, is it? I'm sorry. But yeah, this is the bathroom. Okay, I decided I wanted this bathroom to have a tub and a shower as well, because originally while I was still working on the first floor, let's get out of build mode. I only planned on there having one upstairs bathroom, one downstairs bathroom, but then you'll see that I did change that. Over here, instead of the like super secretive like lab situation that they had going on here, I just took all of the career rewards that were lining the walls here and I put them down here in this basement type thing. So if you head down in this direction, and it's got some creepy like tools in the walls, but it's also, the walls are very like clean and cold and clinical because, you know, this is a part of like a science lab. I don't think that they're ever really going to use these. I don't think I've had them use any of these career rewards since like Nervous Subject moved out a long time ago, but they're nice to have. I think they're a part of like the iconic Beaker story. I didn't want to get rid of him completely and just make this another boring suburban family, so that was my idea. And then up here, everything is a bit more normal. We have like a chess table. I also put a treadmill, which at first glance looks really out of place in this very academic corner. Also, ignore that part of the wall sticking through. You don't see that. We don't see that. But yeah, I actually decided to put this here because it was going to go in the basement. It was supposed to be part of like a, I don't even know what you would call it, like a vital testing center where like, you know, how at the doctor they make you run on a treadmill and stuff. But you know, it is what it is, and I think it's nice for them to have this, especially because Falon is about to become a teenager, and his favorite hobby is fitness, so he'll be able to use that. You have your standard, like, desk, and I think this is a smart computer. It's not. Okay, I might replace that with the smart computer later. We've got some diplomas, some awards, some certificates, and this decoration corner is just that. It's purely decorative, but I think it looks nice. This, of course, is where they would keep all of their files of their testings and their various career things. I don't know. Moving on, upstairs is where it starts to get much plainer because I did run out of steam. Like, I was taking just a really long time to get this done. We still have the stairs in the same spot, leads up to the landing. I moved the bathroom out of like the middle area right here and just pushed it here to this corner. This bathroom wasn't going to be here originally at all, but this is where I struggled. So I wanted Owen to have his own bedroom, right? So I actually turned the upstairs den into his bedroom, which of course makes perfect sense, and then I had to move Circe and Loki's bedroom because otherwise there was no door that was going to lead directly to their bedroom. It was just going to be like the bathroom, and then you'd have to walk through the bathroom to get to their bedroom, which I didn't think made any sense, so I made it the other way around. So they actually have like a really big bedroom that's full of empty space, actually. I will find more things to put in here later, decorative wise, but right now it's just very like utilitarian. And then they have a closet because I couldn't find a dresser that I liked, and then they have this really massive bathroom, which I think it makes sense, you know, for it to be the main bedroom, they have the biggest bathroom. I'm not upset about it. It's just okay. Like, I'm happy with it, and it'll do the job. Over here on the other side of the house, we have Falon's bedroom, and I kept in mind the fact that he is about to become a teenager today, so I actually got rid of like the kiddie stuff, like the toy box and stuff like that. And I think that his parents, also Falon himself, you know, he's very serious, so he's not going to go out of his way to have a lot of like playful toys or colorful distractions in here, so it's just very much like a regular room. I put some stuff in here decorative wise to tie in with his fitness hobby. I think the trophies are kind of a stretch because that would be more related to like sports, but I'm going to choose to believe that like he's a very good runner, and so he's like won races and stuff, so yeah, that's what we're going with. And yeah, I mean, not much else to say about this very plain bedroom. And so this is also where I really struggled, was with the tower situation, because of course in the downstairs it's just part of the kitchen, so it's not a big deal, but in the second and third floors it's just like this empty room. Oh, and I need to replace that door as well. I decided to just make it right now just an area where Falon is keeping his dressers, so like essentially like a walk-in closet, but I just don't have any good custom content that could emulate a walk-in closet that would look nice, in my opinion. So yeah, it's just, he's got some dressers in there, and maybe I'll find something later that will look a bit nicer. And that's essentially it. I didn't change anything about the roof. I actually would like to get them a better telescope, so let me do that now. I don't think that Loki would entertain the idea of like wanting to get abducted, because he's more about other people getting tested rather than himself, but it's still nice to have. I just like having these. Like, I live for the chaos, for the surprises. And I usually like for their telescope to be facing outwards this way, because it's kind of hard to see right now with the roof up, but this way it kind of makes me think Loki is spying on the people of Strangetown up from the top of his hill, so I kind of like that. Alright, well, that was a lot. It was a lot of everything. But we're officially done, and like I said, anything else that I need to do, or I might think of something else later, I'll throw down in the meantime. But let's go ahead and play, because I'm ready. Like I was saying, it's 7 a.m. I've had to put Falon out here, actually, because he was in the way when I was decorating his bedroom. And I need someone to come and help take care of Owen's needs. Something that I had completely forgotten about was actually this right here. Circe is pregnant. I'm quite certain that Loki is the father. It's been a pretty long time, if my memory is serving correctly, since she woohooed. Yeah, she hasn't woohooed with that other guy, at least I don't think she has, since she had Owen. So Loki should be the father of this baby. He has a really high logic skill, and I do have... Oop, that's not where it is. And I do have that mod where if your sim has a high logic skill and their partner gets pregnant and it's not that sim's baby, then they will be able to figure it out and they get upset. And that didn't happen, so I'm assuming it's Loki's baby. Okay, so Circe's actually pretty hungry. Oh, and she's gossiping about Pascal. Oh, and then of course I didn't mention this because I kind of just was going to ignore it, but I did not recolor these stairs to match the stairs from the front of the house. Mostly because it is so time-consuming, like, it's so, takes so much time. Where are you taking those omelets? Oh, no, he's gonna go set the table outside. Okay. Well, Circe's gonna go eat. Falon's gonna go to school. And I think I checked earlier. Yeah, so Loki's actually gonna go to work in, like, an hour. He wants to become a mad scientist to reach the top of the science career, and he has all of the skills and he has all of his friends that he needs, so it's highly likely that when he comes home tonight, he is going to have a promotion. Alright, and he actually has a car, so he's going to be driving himself. Oh dear, I completely forgot about Owen again. Too busy talking. Oh, Owen is actually potty trained, so he could have gone to the toilet himself. I'm just going to have him do that then. So, and because I did not realize that Circe was pregnant again, I completely didn't plan for, like, a third bedroom or anything like that. I really don't think that they have room. I would have to start, like, expanding the house if I wanted to add another room, I think. Why didn't he go? Drive to work. Oh! Someone's calling for an exterminator, I guess. Alright, something weird is happening. Are you stuck out here? Okay, something was weird. I don't know if... because of these walls, like sometimes when I use these walls with this like border type thing, they can't use the stairs. Yeah, I think that might be what's happening. So he couldn't get downstairs, but he wasn't even trying, so that was weird. I think that pop-up for the exterminator came up because, oh god, not the butterflies and the stink and the roaches. Oh my goodness. Anyway, yeah, the butler called for an exterminator. And the exterminator is here. Oh, this little doggy named Grace is rolling around in our garbage. We don't need that, Grace. Get out of here. Okay, and of course she chooses to go and put the outside garbage in her indoor trash compactor. Just imagine the smell. I can't. Alright, so, but anyway, now that Owen is finished with this toy, I can move it out of the way. Just put it behind the couch or something. Yeah, we're gonna go and take care of him some needs. And I think that Owen has already learned all of his toddler skills, so he'll basically just be ready for his birthday tonight. Please? Okay, there he goes. He's gonna eat. Circe's gonna get to break in the bathroom for the first time ever. I Honestly, I might need to feed Owen twice. Eh, I mean, his hunger's good enough. He's now good for a nap. So let's see if I can get him up here in this crib. I don't know if I finished my thought from earlier, but because I didn't plan for another bedroom, I'm just going to have to have one of the other children share a room. It might make sense to just have Owen and the youngest child in a room together. And then, of course, because Falon is older, he'll move off to college eventually. He is a... Well, actually, don't know what his aspiration is going to be. I think he's going to be a popularity sim. I'm actually not sure. I'll have to double check. But whatever he is, he's probably going to go to college no matter what, because I imagine that Loki and Circe, a doctor and a scientist, they're going to say, yeah, you have to go to college. Otherwise, I typically let my sims roll the want to go to college or not, but yeah, in this case, I think it's one of those legacy things where they're going to say, yeah, you definitely are going to college. Alright, so it's only noon, and everyone is going down for a nap, and we'll come back whenever other people come home or someone wakes up. Alright, Loki just got home from work. Let's see if he got his promotion. Oh, he wants to bring home Crystal Vu. I'm going to say yes, because why not? I love seeing her around. Oh, and here we go. Alright, he reached the top of his career, and he just got his lifetime want fulfilled, so he's actually super young for that. He still has 13 days before he even becomes an elder, and he is now already at Platinum Aspiration for life, but honestly, I'm okay with it. And now he can just use his time. Maybe he'll retire once he becomes an elder, and he'll use his time, like, I don't know, creating things at home. I never have my Sims use, like, the workbenches or anything, so it could be an option. Alright, so Crystal Vu is also in the science career, and I think they've actually, yeah, they're acquaintances well enough. Not quite friends, but not quite strangers. So she can stick around for the party tonight. Oh no, Loki is... Things, there have been some unpleasant rumors spreading about you. You should keep a lookout for yourself. Oh, and let's greet PT9. So, interestingly enough, Loki doesn't even know PT9. I'm really surprised about that. So, I don't know. I don't see Loki and Circe as being, like, you know, racist, for lack of a better word, against the aliens the same way that, like, General Buzz Grunt is. I think that Loki and Circe, if anything, would be... Hello, that's a nice outfit, Linda. I think they would be more interested or intrigued, that is, by aliens and, like, the fact that they exist and, like... Oh! That bus scared the crap out of me. Thought something was coming out of my screen. Aw, welcome home, Falon. So it's officially 3 p.m., and I think that I might like for them to have an actual birthday party for the kids. So let's see. Oh, he just became friends with Crystal, so that's nice. We can invite over some friends. We're not going to invite Miranda, I'll tell you that. Maybe I would invite Nina. I mean, they are best friends, but, like, their relationship is deteriorating because, you know, they haven't had contact in quite some time. But Nina's children are around the same age as Falon and Owen. I don't know, I'll consider that. And Pascal as well. He's more of a friend because they work together. Same situation. That's how Cassandra and Loki met. I had someone comment on, I think, maybe my introductions video or something, or I don't know where it was exactly, but someone commented how they thought it was so interesting that Loki and Cassandra were actually best friends. So if I haven't explained that situation in my introductions video, I'll explain again very briefly. That Cassandra and Loki, obviously they work in the same career, that's how they met, and he actually is much older, well, a little bit older, I guess is a better term, than Cassandra, and he was higher up in his career, so he kind of, like, mentored her, and he also was familiar with, like, Mortimer Goth's work, so he knew, like, Cassandra was, like, you know, had a legacy, that is, to uphold, so he kind of, like, helped her through her career, and she's doing much better now, and that's also another reason he became friends with Pascal, because that's her husband. Okay, I'm sorry. Enough talking. Alright, we're gonna throw a birthday party. I'm gonna allow Loki to be the one to throw it because... I don't know, I just feel like he's got more friends probably. So yeah, we're gonna invite Cassandra and Pascal, and I will teleport their children because I feel like that'd be fun that they would bring their kids too. I'm not going to be inviting Nina, I've decided. And honestly, there's really not anybody else. What's funny here is that Loki does have a younger sister, Aaron, who is now married to Daniel Pleasant. He and Aaron really don't have a relationship at all. It's not a negative thing, it's just that they're not really in contact, and I would love to fix that, so I'll invite her. I don't think she's gonna come, but if she doesn't come, I'll just teleport her, because I think that that would be a really nice way as well to kind of connect the family again. Aaron has a bunch of children, so, you know, Falon and Owen have cousins out there that they've never met, and I would like to rectify that. I don't think that he would invite Nervous Spectre. I don't think that they really left things on a good term when Nervous left the house, so yeah, that's actually gonna have to do it. Hopefully people show up so it's not a totally lame party. Let's see. Oh, alright, so someone definitely said no already. It was probably Erin. And I'm gonna put down some things for the birthday party. The main things we're gonna need are gonna be birthday cakes, and so I'm gonna need two cakes, actually. One for Falon and Owen. Oh, okay, right there. And yeah, maybe like a little balloon arch or something. I don't know, it seems kind of like against what Loki and Circe would probably plan for, like, you know, as being very serious Sims, they probably would be the type of people that are like, oh, our children don't need, like, you know, a bunch of toys and balloons and things like that. But I don't know, it's just for the theming of it. Okay. Circe is still asleep. Oh, no, she's not. She's in the bathtub. What am I talking about? So I was actually going to get her to change, but she's changing now. Oh my god, no, Falon's going to sleep. Alright, let's see if I can manage this. Oh gosh, Circe, your outfit. We are going to dress Owen in his everyday wear. Please? Okay, I see that the butler is coming. I'm honestly going to dismiss the butler. I find him to be terribly annoying when there are toddlers in the lot, even though I do have the mod. Put me down. Put me down. Oh my god. Okay, never mind. Already off to a terrible start. So, Crystal is here. Cassandra and Pascal showed up. Like I suspected, Erin did not. So, I mean, it could be just the fact that she's at school. Or, I mean, work. Yeah, they are 0/0. They literally, like, just don't know each other at all, which is really sad to me. So I'm going to summon her. Alrighty, so I actually decided to not only teleport Erin, but I also teleported her husband Daniel. Unfortunately, their children are too young to attend the party. Their twins, Gemma and Evan, are both toddlers, and their youngest Vince is still an infant, so they can't really participate in the party anyway. So what I did was I actually decided to teleport over Noah Pleasant, who is he is Daniel's son. He has no relation to Erin or the Beakers. However, you know, he is Erin's stepson, and he's about the same age as Falon. I believe he's actually really close to becoming a teenager as well. So I thought it might be nice to have him here as well. And I really just wanted an excuse to have another kid here. Oh, and that reminds me that I actually also wanted to teleport, Jonathan Lothario, I think is who it is. Yes. So Jonathan actually has no relation to Pascal. He is Pascal's stepson because he's the son of Cassandra and Dawn. But of course, just like the situation with Erin and Daniel, Pascal and Cassandra's actual biological child is either an infant or a toddler. I don't remember. So yeah, this is what we're working with. So we're going to get Circe down here. She really wants to take a bath for some reason, even though she is, she's not dirty, but okay. And I just realized that they have nothing to eat here. I probably should have ordered some pizza or something. Loki is talking crap about Lilith, and I only just noticed that Cassandra has new default hair placement. And I took off her glasses, I guess, because she's not wearing any. But she's so cute. It's maybe a little young for her, but I'm not mad at it. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and get Loki chatting up the guests, because why not? Falon, I forgot he went to sleep. He needs to wake up. I know you're very tired. I might cheat his needs a little bit, actually. But I would like Falon to come down and also kind of get to know some of the kids, maybe. Let's click on Noah. I don't think that... Oh, he actually already knows Noah, but he doesn't know Jonathan, so that's cool. Jonathan is much younger. Christopher Lothario is actually the oldest of Cassandra's children, so I guess I could teleport him in, too. It just kind of didn't seem like something he would be interested in attending. It's making me nervous because we're still at a snoozer, but it doesn't always go up right away. Oh! Don't know what happened there. And it's almost 6 o'clock. Luckily, I do have the mod where if you don't age them up by 6 p.m. while you're at a birthday party, it actually just saves it. They don't age up on their own, and that way you don't have the risk of having like a bad birthday just because you didn't blow out the candles. So we're going to go ahead and go do that now. Just get it out of the way. Oh, and we just went up to not bad, which is great. Daniel has raided our fridge and now is walking far, far away, apparently, to put down the chip bag. Oh, he's going to put it under the... Okay, thank you. Okay, let's see. Okay, I just did a quick save, and let's go ahead and get you aged up, Falon. Okay, he is an Aries. Oh my. I completely forgot that I re-enabled the cutscene. Wow. Whew, that was so loud. Of course, when I edit this back, I'm sure I'm going to lower the volume a considerable amount, but in my ears, that was just blasting. And it's actually really unfortunate that you can't change the cutscene volume, considering I have all the other game volume on almost minimum. But okay. So it turns out, yes, Falon is going to be a popularity sim, and seeing how he is extremely outgoing and active, I can see that for him. I've mentioned before, I always think of the popularity, or not popularity people, but the outgoing sims who are extremely grouchy. I like to think that they're kind of like, you know, a bully, or maybe not even a bully, but like kind of a person that pokes fun at people for, you know, laughs. I don't know. It just seems like one of those kind of vibes, and considering the family he comes from, I think it makes sense. His current turn-ons are influential sims and hardworking sims, and his turn-off is black hair, but I am going to re-roll that because I like to just roll completely new ones if I feel like they don't make sense. So I rolled number 2, and so for a hair color, that would be red hair, so he's going to like redheaded sims. And hard worker, I'm not going to keep that one. Maybe I would give it to him again later in life, but it's kind of hard for a teenage sim to have a turn on for hard workers because there are no teenagers that would have a 6+ level in their career, so just something to think about. Instead, I am actually going to choose fitness because his favorite hobby is fitness, and he actually has quite a lot of enthusiasm in it, and I think that makes sense. I would choose active or athletic, but I'm not sure like what that necessarily entails. I don't know if it's the same thing as like an active personality point. I'm just gonna go with fitness. And now his current turn off is think, but I think I clicked that, so I'm going to again randomize. Oh, and I got number 1, so his turn off is gonna be stink, I guess. That's fine. He really likes clean people. Okay, we're not gonna age anyone else with him. This is his outfit. I'm not mad at it, but I'll probably change it because I know I just have better things. If you couldn't tell from a lot of my like decorations, hairs, and custom content, I go really CC heavy. So I just like prefer to. Why are you trying to play catch? Oh my gosh, Loki just got scared by his son aging up. And this party is flying by. There's only 2 minutes left, so we need to hurry and get Owen aged up as well. Everyone has to find their places. It takes a whole damn... There we go. Okay, that's actually a lot of people are here. A lot more people than I thought for some reason. Yay! Oh, and I see here she wants to hire an exterminator. Well, you already did. Okay. And so, honestly, Falon and Owen's personalities are exact same, considering that Loki and Circe's personalities... That is absolutely wild, and of course, Falon is throwing away Owen's cake. That's nice, it's really nice. Wow, okay, so anyway, I just, like, look at this kid. Alright, look at that, oh my god! Okay, yeah, I was going to say, look at that face! I had to have that, okay. And then I was going to say, look at this face. Where the hell are you? And honestly, tell me if you can see the difference, because besides the facial hair, they're basically the same person. Those are some really dominant genes. My only hope for this house is that Loki and Circe only have sons, because I feel like on a girl, it's just so much worse. It's just so much worse. Like I said before, though, Falon honestly turned out pretty good. Poor thing is still so tired, but I want him to meet his aunt. Where did she go? Oh, she's on the toilet. I wanted him to meet Aaron, because I don't think they've met. No, they haven't. And you, I would like to know Christopher. Sorry if my camera's going everywhere. I might need to get rid of these trellises. They're kind of in the way when I'm trying to see things. Oh wow, Circe's somehow about to crap her pants. No, you're not going to sleep. Come here. We're going to talk to your aunt, Aaron. I just think it's really sad that they haven't had the opportunity to even get to know each other yet at this point, so I don't know. I might be forcing it a little bit, but I don't really feel bad about it. Okay, Loki. Oh wow, the phone was ringing. Some bartender is calling to speak to Falon already. Like, relax, he just turned into a teenager. Alright, so I don't think Circe's gonna have the energy to participate in the... Oh, was Daniel just poking Crystal Vu? I don't know, that looked like some kind of, like, altercation there. That was weird. PT9 and Pascal are having the time of their lives up there. So that's nice. Okay, so I think that he's... Oh, he wants to be friends with Christopher now. Or, I keep calling him Christopher. Oh my god, this is Jonathan. Oopsie. No, this is Jonathan. I forgot Christopher is a teenager now. Okay. Maybe I will let you talk to your aunt a little bit. I don't know if Falon has had the opportunity to talk to Jonathan. Yeah, we only have 20 seconds left in the party, so... Oh wow, Loki. It's just the way that he conversates. Even if they get like positive relationship points from it, he's just like mean mugging them the whole time. Who's taking a bath? Crystal Vu? Who said you could take a bath at my party? Alright, so shockingly, even though I feel like not a lot really happened, we are ending the party with a good time. But that's nice. That's nice. And now everybody can go home. Alright, and then you, poor Falon, is so exhausted. He wants to play catch, but I'm sorry, you don't have the energy. We're gonna send Falon to bed. And, oh no, and I need to actually buy a bed for Owen. I think, like I was saying, I'm going to keep the crib and, of course, stuff like that, but I also think that for the time being, this stuff can live in Loki and Circe's room. They have the room for it, so, like, it's fine. That's what we're rolling with. That's it. That is it for the time being. And as we learn more about who Owen is and what his interests are, we can update as necessary. I'm going to do a quick save, and then I want to check and see what his outfit looks like. Okay, so we're going to gussy up and check clothes. I can see, I think I already know what his everyday outfit is, just from the thumbnail. Yeah. I don't hate it, honestly. It is summertime. And... Okay, he's basically wearing the same outfit for his athletic. This is his outerwear. He really won't be needing that too much, unless he goes to Pleasant View or Ronaville. So yeah, it looks like just some standard, like, text or script or something. Oops. And I don't know what that is, like a person jumping on his shorts? I actually think I'm gonna let him keep it, but we are gonna change his hair. So I downloaded I'm now using the all-in-one, and I think that it came with like some store hairs or something. So this is new. And I tell you what, I'm on a clay hair kick right now, so I'm looking for clay hairs, but this hair, this hair really just makes me question it all. Like, wow, what a missed opportunity. Alright, so he looks dead at me, and I feel like I gave him new eyebrows, and I feel like he looks even more evil now, somehow. I don't know, he looks too old for his little body, it's scaring me. But it looks good, he looks good. Alright, so it's about the end of the night, so I'm gonna go ahead and let Owen go to bed. Gonna get rid of these balloons, and we're gonna settle in, and that marks pretty much the end of our second round, or first night in this round. Alright, so I just had something really scary happen, and it was my first time ever experiencing that. Oh my god, stop why did she change into her regular clothes? Luckily she's got a pregnancy morph, but that looks uncomfortable with the jeans. Anyway, yeah, I just had my very first experience with pink soup, and it happened so quickly, like, it started to take over the whole lot, like a plague, that I panicked and I exited out, like, really fast, so... luckily I had saved, of course, but that was my very first experience. I've always talked about how, or I've told people that is, how I've never experienced pink soup, that's never been a problem for me, but this is my first new video on my new PC, that is, and I think that, you know, I'm gonna have to go through and do some fixes to prevent that from happening, because, oh my god. Alright, and of course I cannot do anything with this plate. Like, why? Why do you do this to me, game? Why do you keep people... in my game from being able to clean up after themselves. Anyway, and yeah, so I'm just gonna have to remember to start doing more frequent saves and hopefully avoid that. And I feel like I also should probably start using a little less custom content. Almost every single thing in this frame right now is custom content, so yeah, I need to slow my roll a little bit, I guess. Of course, Loki did not get to raise his relationship with his sister very much. There are now only 4/2. but maybe in the future, like, I'll have her invite him over and vice versa, and I would like for them to start kind of getting to know each other a little bit better. I don't really see, like, a good reason that they fell off. I think that it's more like Loki has just always been absorbed in his own thing. I think that he hasn't really been a big brother in the way of, like, he's not really gone out of his way to look out for Eren. There's a big enough age difference, I feel, that he would have already probably been out of the house when she was growing up, so... yeah, it's just distant siblings. It happens sometimes. Alright, it's 12:45. Loki actually wants to get another skill point, but he doesn't specify in what. I assume he probably wants to maximize his cooking skill, so maybe we'll work on that later. But for right now, it's bedtime. Okay, it is now 6 a.m. on Saturday. The boys are waking up. Oh, I just noticed that this bed is kind of sticking into the wall a little bit. That's a little annoying. We are going to spawn an ACR adjuster, and we are going to randomize Falon's gender preference, and it looks like he came out to be straight, so I'm just going to lock that in. We're actually going to change this into something else as well and hide it somewhere on the lot. I like to have these nearby just as well as the sim blenders. Oh, he's got a drawing. Where should I stick that? Oh, I thought you could hang these on the wall. But I guess in this case it wants to go... anyway, he doesn't need to hang it, but... yeah. So now we are going to check the clothes for Falon and see if I need to change anything. Like I said, I don't mind his everyday outfit, but I do think that I have something better. And I love the fact that he aged up into a sweater. Like, it's so perfect, but it is summertime and... they live in the desert, so I think maybe I could find something cooler for him. Like, not literally, but like, cooler as in temperature. Okay, so I completely backtracked on what I just said, because I saw this outfit and I thought it was just too perfect to pass out on. And I think that Falon would be the type of sim, because he's so serious, he would prioritize looking suave over being, like, temperature cool. And we are going to also change his appearance. I'd like to give him maybe some different glasses as well. Okie dokie, so I actually just kept his glasses the same, but I just gave him black frames to match his outfit a little bit better. And I decided to keep his hair because I kind of like it. Unfortunately, that the eyebrows I wanted to give him, they were so light, or maybe his brows were just so small, like so thin, that it looked like he didn't have eyebrows, so I decided to go with these other ones. They're still like clay match, but they just are a little bit darker than his hair, but that's okay. My eyebrows are darker than my hair, and it's fine. And we're going to ignore the fact that his glasses go into his hair. It's fine. Alright, I'm excited for Falon to be out there in the world. It's nice to have another teenager to play with. Okay, and Owen is awake, and there was something that I wanted to do with him, but now I'm struggling to remember what it was. Oh, I wanted to roll to see if he needed to wear glasses. Yeah, I like to do this when my Sims age up into children, because, of course, that's the age where they can first start wearing glasses. And if they have one parent that wears glasses, there's a 50-50 chance that they will have to wear glasses. Heads for yes, tails for no. And we got tails, so actually... Owen does not need to wear glasses. And I like to type it in their bio so that I don't forget later that I already rolled for it. Okay, that's pretty much the only thing I ever put in their bios is stuff like that. Or, like, if they got married, I put their maiden name so I don't forget. I don't really do individual sim bios very often. Okay, I wanted to also check with the ACR adjuster to see how close we are to having a baby. So 57 hours, so they had the baby at 75, and this is the last day we're playing with them, so my fingers are crossed that we'll get to see the baby this round. I think it'll be cutting it really close. I'm really bad at math, so maybe you're watching this thinking like, duh, Brianna, that's plenty of time, but I don't know for sure. It is a Saturday, so neither Circe or Loki have to go to work. She's pregnant, so that's why she's not going to go. And of course, the kids don't have to go to school. Normally, I like to send my Sims on Saturdays if they're all off together. I like to send them to like a community lot or something. But I'm not totally sure that it's going to let Circe go since she's technically so close to having a baby. So maybe we'll just find something else to do at the house, or maybe we'll just let them kind of do their own thing. Falon's fun is actually really low. And the only thing I like can think of that they can do for fun and also gain fitness enthusiasm is to jump rope. I think that that usually helps their fun a lot. So I'll have him do that. I just noticed that they had the stereo and they didn't turn on the stereo during the party last night one time. And that's unusual. I always have music playing during my parties. Circe's a little hungry. I want to see what's in the fridge. She does want to serve a meal, but I want to see what's in here first. There's already omelets, so let's just have some of those. I know that the food in the fridge technically never goes bad, but I still like to eat it first anyway. It's the waste not want not in me. Falon is actually very hungry as well, so I'm gonna have him get a plate. Actually, they all are. How did I not notice that? Loki isn't. Loki, all he wants is to for Falon to get a scholarship, which he's very early in his teenagehood for him to be applying for scholarships to college. And then he wants to stargaze. His favorite hobby is science. So yeah, he's actually really high up in enthusiasm in science as well. What was that? Are you not able to get in the shower? Oh. What was the butler freaking out about? Thank you for being my guinea pig, Loki. Circe's down here having a lovely breakfast with her sons. Oh, how darling. I love the moments like this. I never knew that Circe's glasses were purple. I actually find it really interesting that Circe's son, who looks more like her, has to wear glasses, but her son that looks just like Loki doesn't. So it's even more solidifying his stance as like Loki's clone. I wonder if Circe's embryos had anything to do with making this child. I swear. I was actually just looking at Loki's lifetime aspiration benefits, especially now that he's already gotten lifetime platinum aspiration. He still has one point that he can use. I'm still not going to calculate any secondary aspirations for anyone in the Uberhood yet. If I'm going to do it at all, I'm not sure. I'm still debating on that, which is another reason I haven't. I don't need to give him friends in high places because he already has the highest level career, so I'm actually going to give him slower need, decay, fun, and hunger. The summon aliens one would arguably be much more fun, but like I was saying earlier, I don't necessarily think that Loki's the type of sim who would want to be abducted. He just wants to hear about other people being abducted. That's kind of my take on that. Circe unfortunately does not have any remaining points to use, and I only let my adult sims have aspiration benefits. It just makes it more fun. I like my sims to go through their struggle period a little bit. I'm trying to think like which children, or like teenagers I guess, are in the same age group as Falon, so let me go and think about that for a minute. So from what I can see in my notes, some of the kids that should be in the same age range as Falon would be Bruno Monty and Damon Monty, which I do recall two of those sims just aged up to teenagers, as well as Henry Curious. However, Henry Curious lives downtown, so we won't be playing him for quite some time, so he hasn't aged up yet. So yeah, it seems like just those sims, honestly, and then the sims before him that are a little bit older would be like Talia Cap and Vega Curious. I think maybe letting Falon get to know Vega could be interesting. She is a romance sim, and she's straight, and then Falon is straight, so, you know, I don't know, there could be some romance there, who knows? Alright, so back to our regularly scheduled programming. We are going to continue jumping rope for his fitness enthusiasm and his fun. Owen is having a bath. Okay, for some reason we're all the way out here. I think they were playing catch or something. Oh, hello, Clarence. I think that it's really sweet. Like, I really do like Loki and Circe together. I like their relationship. I think that they, it's really nice that they've bonded over their, like, you know, genuine, like, similar interests, I should say. However, I think it is unfortunate that they have both strayed from the marriage, but maybe they're over it. Maybe that was just a phase. Maybe they're back on track with each other. Yeah, I like to think that they're gonna be just fine. I would love for them to practice using some of these. They never use these. I think, oh, we can make a virus. I want him to make a virus. I think that's just gonna wind up probably getting him sick, but I never have seen that option before, so I want to try it. Oh yeah, that's interesting. I really never use the career rewards. They're just like not in my typical like gameplay, but I do find them to be interesting. Oh wow, okay, so usually I know that the medicines you can make would be blue. These are green. It says virus complete. Be careful what you do with this. Well, what can I do with it? My only option is to dispose. Well, that's just unfortunate. Oh, you know, I could have tried picking it up. Maybe I could have tried picking it up. Let's have him do it again. Practice makes perfect after all. Okay, yeah, virus is complete once again. This time I'm going to try to pick... Oh, okay. Well, that answers my question. I cannot pick it up. That's kind of lame. I don't know, maybe there's something about that that I'm missing, but if you know anything about that, be sure to let me know, but I'm pretty sure. I've never seen that option before. Maybe it only pops up since he's got such a high, like, skill level or something like that. Not sure. Where did Owen go? Oh, he's just sitting in here. I think that it'd be nice if he played chess with his big brother. They don't really have, like, I mean, they're really close to being friends, but they don't really have a friendship just yet. Mostly because it's hard for children to interact with babies, but now they have plenty of opportunity. Falon and Owen both are going to be a teenager and a child, respectively, for exactly 7 days. Oh, not him cheating! Seemed like he was going to cheat just now. It's hard to say yet at this time whether or not Falon and Owen are going to follow in their parents' footsteps. Are they going to become, like, evil necessarily? I mean, just because they're super grouchy doesn't necessarily mean they have to be evil. But, I mean, it is... Okay, Crystal wants to speak to Loki. It is kind of what the game is kind of leading you towards, how they are doing these, like, sadistic testings and stuff like that on Nervous Subject. And they also have a creepy dungeon in there, essentially, in their house. I'm just gonna give Crystal a quick ring because, I mean, Loki doesn't have very many friends, so I kind of want to retain the ones that he does have. But like I was saying, I'm just not sure whether or not they're going to kind of follow in that same pathway, you know what I mean? Like, it could be that Falon's gonna grow up and want to do something completely different. Maybe not even want to be a scientist at all. Maybe not even want to be a doctor. Okay, wow. Yeah, Owen is cheating left, right, and center. I actually think that it would be nice because he just ended his conversation with Crystal. To actually see if Aaron will come over. I highly doubt it. Where even is she? Okay, there she is. I doubt she's gonna come over, but... Okay, I see here that she wants to bring a friend, so I'm gonna let her do that. And hopefully it's someone interesting and not just, like, a bartender. These two are gaining logic skills left, right, and center. I don't know, I think... Do they get a skill building bonus in summertime? I thought that was just winter. Or fall, I mean. I'm not sure, but whatever. Oh my goodness, Aaron brought Rip Grunt. Okay, I'm totally fine with that. Come here. I'm totally fine with that. Any excuse to see our man Rip again. Oh no, Aaron, stay far away from him. Stay far away. I did not mean to do that. Okay, oh, that, okay, it looks like... Obviously, Aaron is just trying to catch butterflies, but why did it have to be right around Loki's neck? I don't even know what angle I want to get a screenshot of this. Okay, so it's 6:30 p.m. Everybody just aged up one day, and just checking one more time. So we're currently at 68 hours, so I was right. Circe is going to have this baby sometime tonight. which I'm so excited about. I'm nervous that it's going to be a girl. Like I was saying, I don't really want her to have a girl. That's so mean, but I also like the idea of her and Loki only having sons. We're actually just going to dismiss this butler because he's kind of doing a whole lot of nothing. He didn't even make dinner. At the rate things are going, I don't really expect the two of these people to become friends, but yeah, I would just like for them to at least speak to each other, you know? Okay, the boys were just having the times of their lives, but I just noticed that Owen is about to fall out. He's so tired. It's 8 o'clock. I'm just going to send him to bed. His other needs are fine. But, oh yeah, I need to get rid of this table out here. Or maybe it was the desk she was about to go to. The reason that I always put centerpieces on the kitchen tables is to avoid them automatically setting food out for people that aren't going to eat it. But then some of the custom content desks that I use, like this one, are also registered as tables, so then if there's no homework on them... Okay, please don't wash the hamburgers. Loki, stop. Anyway, but what I was saying... sometimes... I don't even know what I was saying anymore. Okay, so now we're having a nice little family dinner with Rip Grunt. Let's see if Aaron will come to dinner. I would like for her and Circe and Owen to, this is Falon, I'm sorry, to have a talk. I'm probably going to confuse people's names a lot, especially with the ones that sound a lot similar, like Falon and Owen and Aaron and all of that. Rip is talking about how he recently got a promotion, which I don't seem to recall. Maybe he's lying. It's been a while since he got promoted at work, to my knowledge. Now Aaron's talking about winning awards. So out of pure curiosity, I wanted to see how old Aaron was in comparison to Loki, and whereas he is 11 days from becoming an elder, she is only 16 from becoming an elder. So actually, he's not that much older than her at all, only basically 5 days, which for some reason I was thinking it was more like 10 or 15. Maybe he just seems that old. I'm not sure. So he's actually not that much older than her, and she is a prep cook in the culinary career. I kind of needed to remind myself of that. And then Rip here, he wants to invite Melissa over. Oh, he did get a promotion. See, here I am just ragging on him. He did get a promotion. He used to be a party DJ, but he is now a projectionist, so I must have just forgotten that. When you only play like one household a month, basically, it can get kind of fuzzy on the details. Flirting. I don't know who this guy is, but he wants to talk to my youngest son. I think not. Why do I have all these strange men calling to speak to my children? I'm a little scared. Alright, so even though Loki's getting kind of tired, I am going to let him stargaze. Go ahead. What did I do? Hold on, let me see. So I think that, okay, I know what's happening. Just like I said earlier, I need to delete these walls by the stairs. I'll fix it up better in a minute, but let me see if that changes anything. No. Strange. Okay, I know you can go up the house stairs, right? I know you can come out here. Can you not go up here? Oh my gosh. How many light bulbs does it take, Brianna? Okay, one more time. There it is. Yeah, so something about, like, I guess it's the border on these walls. Okay, he's like, thank God I made it up here. I'm gonna have to think about what I want to do here. Because it can't just be empty like this. It looks so bad. Maybe a fence? I don't know. Falon's being a good boy and cleaning up and putting the food away. Thank you, Falon. Oh, and I see here he wants to be friends with Aaron. That's so sweet. Maybe I can get them to hang out and then it might be a lot easier. The downside for Falon being that he's a popularity sim, he's always going to want to be friends with people. However, his main issue is going to be the fact that he is super grouchy, so it's going to be really hard for him to agree with people and make those relationship points. Alright, so he's pretty much done. It's now midnight. It's after midnight, so I'm going to send Loki to bed. I kind of wanted him to already be awake for the pregnancy. Actually, yeah, we have like one more hour. Hopefully he can make it. Oh my god, Aaron, you're being decapitated right now. I swear, the things they do. Okay, come on, Circe. There she goes. It's baby time. Okay, the time is upon us. I don't know why I'm so excited. It's like, I have babies all the time, but I just get so excited, especially in the Uberhood, because we're playing so slowly that it's nice to see it growing, even if it is just one little baby at a time. I just realized that they're not running over. Okay, give me a boy.
Ooh.
Yes.
It's a boy. Oh, Kablonabana. Huh? What? Sibley? Ramletige!
Okay, so first of all, I think I remember why I turned off the cutscenes, because they always put you inside the dang furniture. Like, what is the point of this? Anywho, something I completely neglected to think about is what we're gonna name this kid, so give me a moment while I figure that out. Alrighty, so I looked up some names that started with D, because it's the letter of the alphabet that we're on for our babies, and then I got inspired and I decided to specifically look up Scandinavian baby boy names. And I don't know if it's necessarily Scandinavian, I don't know if I can trust the baby name website that I got this off of, but I saw it and I liked it. Davin. So it's like Devin and David kind of like mixed together, I don't know, so Davin. I like it a lot, and it also ends with an N, just like Falon and Owen, so I feel like it's kind of keeping up a trend. So that's what we're going with. So we just welcomed little baby Davin Beaker into the world. Of course, right now he looks perfectly normal, just a regular little baby. So we'll have to come back next round and see what he looks like as a toddler. I see that he does have Circe's brown eyes, which is nice. That actually makes me think, like, what color are Falon? Falon has his father's gray. Okay, his father doesn't have eyes. Oh my goodness. I was trying to... His father actually has blue eyes, he really can't see, so I guess Falon's eyes come from an ancestor. And unfortunately, Owen is asleep, so I can't see what color his eyes are, but I assume... Oh, I think they're dark blue. Yeah, I think they're just like his dad's. So yay! So they're all a little bit the same and a little bit different, all in different ways. Cool, and I'm glad that Erin got to be here for this as well. So she's gonna get to meet her next nephew. Let's talk to baby Davin. Maybe if anyone... I've never heard of the name Davin before, but maybe if anyone here has ever heard it before, and you know the actual, like, I don't know, context or something behind it, just let me know if it's a bad name, and I might change it, but I think it sounds cool. Alright, so it's Sunday at 2 a.m., which basically it's like the end of this round. We're just going to take care of some routine things, feed a bottle to Davin, Loki's gonna go to sleep. And yeah, that's pretty much it for them. Okay, so it is now Sunday at 6 a.m. and the only person who had enough energy to wake up on time was little Owen. So that's okay. So Owen was the only one that was asleep last night when his baby brother was born, but of course, thankfully because it's The Sims, he already has a natural relationship with Davin. So that's good. So we now officially have a middle child, and I was correct. He has blue eyes. Just like his dad. I'm not laughing at Owen, okay? I'm just appreciating his uniqueness, alright? So that's what we're doing. Anyway, so but yeah, that marks the end of this family's rotation. It was eventful, it was exciting, it was a lot of things. We saw not one, not two, but three births, technically. two birthdays and one birth, and we now have another addition to the Beaker family, and another little boy to live on with the Beaker name, which is a whole other thing. I don't know yet if maybe Owen or Davin are gonna wind up maybe marrying someone and taking their last names, but Falon, since he's the heir, he's definitely gonna be passing on the Beaker name. To who? I don't know, but hopefully as we play the other rounds in the other households with other teenagers growing up, we'll be able to find somebody who might be a good love match for Falon, which is exciting. I always love pairing up my teen sims and then seeing if things work out or if they don't, and that's okay too. So yeah, I just want to say thank you guys so much for watching. I know that this one was probably a little bit longer because I went from playing one single sim and thinking, oh, that was fast, to playing this whole big house. And technically it took me like 7 hours to play this family because I took so long to redecorate the house, but that was my fault. Next time we come back to Strangetown, we are going to be playing one of the most infamous families in Strangetown, if you do ask me, the Smith family with PT9, Jenny, and their two sons, Jack and Jacob. Their eldest children, of course, Johnny and Jill, are both grown and out of the house, so we'll have to play them separately later. We've actually already played Johnny earlier, he lives in Pleasant View now, but anyway, Yeah, I'm super excited to get this to them, and I'm sure that I'm going to be feeling much the same way as I did when we came into the Beaker house. I'm going to need to remodel the Smith family home, but that's okay. I'm actually kind of having fun with it, and I'm kind of having fun, like, learning how to do that stuff myself. I usually just download lots that are custom made or, like, remodeled and stuff like that, but so it's kind of nice to get to do it myself. If you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel, and if you'd like to, feel free to follow me over on Twitch as well. I do stream The Sims 2 content every single week, as well as some variety streams sprinkled in there, and I will leave the links down below. I'll see you guys next time. Have a great rest of your night, and bye.